just one day. Complained about the mess of not having offered a seat. Good values I've got nowadays, she murmured. This is but one observable scenario in this fast-changing world. People come and go, work, work, work. Busy, busy, busy. No time to reflect. No time to notice other people's needs. No time for sensing others' concerns. And worse, even sometimes, no time for them. Isn't this alarming? Well, the answer is a resounding yes. A biting reality. Finally, just back in the olden times, when Filipinos had a very strong spirit of nationalism and patriotism, in which everyone used to sing the Philippine national anthem with ardent fervor in their hearts and minds. Their social and cultural values were burning like fire, as most they showed in each member of the family. They used to kiss the hands of the elders every time he gets home. The close ties in every Filipino family makes a strong bond among individual members. It even creates a more unique family fabric, the so-called extended family. Such family solidarity depicts the ones of sympathy and empathy among them, that with one itself, everybody is there to offer a hand. Their spiritual values were so expressive that when the clock strikes at 6 in the evening, everyone hastened to step the gold room for the angelus. But do these values still dominate the Filipino's heart at these times? Maybe yes, maybe no to some. Filipino families, is it globalization? Technology? Or just a normal piece of time? Well, change is inevitable, right? But good values must remain unchanged, no matter what happens. It must dwell in the hearts of every Filipino forever to maintain its dignity all over the world. We must stand with heads up high and be proud of the uniqueness and fineness of our character. And this character must be something we must nurture and must run in our blood. Let's try to recapitulate everything and put the Filipino character in a closer view. Filipino values can be both subjective and objective. An example is family solidarity. A sort of a family that stays together, stays together. In the light of historical values, patriotism and nationalism were so strong before we gained our total independence. Through the passing of time, when democracy has been attained, these values have been placed behind number other values. This shows that values are dynamic according to the demands of time. Furthermore, Filipino values are ambivalent. Ambivalent in the sense that they can be seen both positively and negatively. Let me quote and unquote Father Coral's best ideas in his essay entitled Understanding the Filipino Value System. Are Filipino values good or bad? He says that Filipino values are ambivalent, in the sense that they are potential for good or evil. A help or hindrance to personal and national development, depending on how they're understood, practiced, or lived. They can be used in a good or evil context. An example of this is makikisama sa kabuktutan o sa kaunatan or camaraderie for destruction or progress. Filipino values have both positive and negative aspects, depending on the context in which their family. In a social system or atmosphere of extreme insecurity, the positive qualities of the Filipino take on negative and ugly appearances. For example, unang na nag-awkward debt of gratitude, hindi ko makikusap or favor, nepotism and cronyism. Magpakayari ng kapangyarihan or the possession of power and their abuse could lead to class distinction or the manahas mahina system or strong weak system. Here are shame can become pakitang tao or gaya-gaya or showing intimidation effect. Machismo or aggressive masculinity is part responsible for the kilito system and the doble cara morality. These are but the few values common in the Filipino that can be so-called double standards of morality or split double Christianity. Hence, by looking at those common Filipino values, one can choose now between the right the wrong, between the wholesome and the unwholesome, and between the good or the evil. Now, choose. What Filipino values are worth your valuing? It is up to you if we all are capable and susceptible to change. After we discover such values, it is your choice. What you see, act, and advocate. As we can see right around, lifestyle has become different. But no matter how we are caught by the winds of change, there must be a character of the Filipino that must be worth preserving. Gone are those days that we need to be wary sa barong tagal and barong sayo in order to reveal the modesty of a Filipino man and woman. Physical outlook is not so important now. What is more important is the inward character. The good values that are instilled in our hearts and inculcated in our minds by our forefathers. That must be passed from this generation onwards. Personally, I see, act and advocate. What's timely, necessary, indispensable in building a more just and humane society, as stipulated in the preamble of our institution. I go once again for the words of Father Rosman of transforming the field of values towards the structural goal. Because we need both external structural and internal cultural field. Christian faith points to the kind of values education needed for the youth of the day for national reconstruction. Now, it's time for you to reflect. Thank you. Valuing Filipino values.